How the Mischievous Little Fish Became a Hero.
Once upon a time in the vast and colourful ocean, there was a little fish named Finn. Finn was a curious and adventurous baby fish, always eager to explore the underwater world and meet new friends. But there was something special about Finn. He had a mischievous side that often got him into trouble. One sunny morning, Finn woke up feeling particularly mischievous. Instead of joining the school of fish for their daily swim, he decided to sneak away to the forbidden part of the reef, where the older fish had warned him not to go. They said there were dangerous creatures lurking there, but Finn couldn't resist the temptation. As Finn swam deeper into the forbidden reef, he encountered a grouchy old hermit crab named Crusty. "Hey, you! What are you doing in my territory?" Crusty snapped, waving his pincers threateningly. Finn giggled nervously and replied, "I'm just exploring, Mr. Crusty. I didn't mean to intrude." But Crusty was not amused. Youngsters these days have no respect for boundaries. "You better leave before you get hurt," he grumbled. Finn didn't listen and continued his misadventure. He soon found himself in front of a beautiful but mysterious cave. It was said that a grumpy octopus named Octo lived there, and no fish dared to disturb him. However, Finn's naughty streak pushed him forward, and he swam right into the cave. Inside, he found Octo, who was napping. Finn couldn't resist playing a prank on the sleeping octopus. He swam up to Octo and tickled one of his tentacles. Octo woke up with a start, his eyes wide with surprise and irritation. "Why, you little rascal! Who dares to disturb my peaceful nap?" Octo roared. Finn gulped but managed a sheepish smile. "Sorry, Mr. Octo. I couldn't resist having a bit of fun." Octo's stern expression softened as he chuckled. "You have spunk, kid, I'll give you that. But remember, not all creatures have a sense of humor. Be careful with your pranks next time." Finn nodded, realizing that his mischievous behavior could have serious consequences. He thanked Octo for his advice and promised to be more careful in the future. As Finn swam back towards his school, he reflected on his escapade. He understood that his curiosity and mischievous nature were not inherently bad, but he needed to channel them in a more responsible and considerate way. From that day on, Finn still had his playful moments, but he became more mindful of his actions. He learned to respect boundaries and consider the feelings of others. His friends appreciated his adventurous spirit and humor, and together, they explored the ocean, forming a close-knit group that always looked out for one another. And so, the little naughty fish named Finn grew up to be a wise and kind fish, who shared his tales of adventure with the younger generations, encouraging them to explore while also reminding them to be mindful of their actions. And in the colorful world of the ocean, Finn's legacy of playful curiosity lived on. As Finn grew older, his reputation as a wise and kind fish spread throughout the ocean. Other young fish looked up to him, seeking his guidance and friendship. He became the go-to fish for solving disputes and helping others navigate through challenges. One day, while exploring a coral reef with his friends, Finn noticed a group of younger fish being picked on by a bully fish named Spike. Spike was much larger than the others and enjoyed intimidating smaller fish for his amusement. Finn knew he couldn't let this behavior continue. Swimming over to Spike, Finn calmly asked, "Hey, why are you bothering these little ones? Can't we all just get along?" Spike sneered, "Mind your own business, wise guy. It's fun to see them squirm." Finn wasn't one to back down, and he replied firmly, "Bullying isn't cool, and it doesn't make you any better. Let's find a way to have fun without hurting others." Spike hesitated for a moment, surprised that someone was standing up to him. Deep down, he felt lonely and insecure, using his tough exterior to hide his feelings. Finn sensed this and saw an opportunity to help him change. Instead of resorting to a fight, Finn decided to invite Spike to join their group in a more positive way. "You know, we have a lot of fun exploring the ocean and discovering new places. You're more than welcome to come along," Finn said warmly. Spike was taken aback by Finn's offer. Nobody had ever invited him to join before. Slowly, he nodded and said, "Okay, I guess I could give it a try." From that day on, Finn and his friends welcomed Spike into their group. As they explored together, Spike's tough exterior softened, and he began to feel a sense of belonging he had never experienced before. Finn's kindness and acceptance taught Spike the value of friendship and compassion. Over time, Spike's bullying tendencies faded away, and he became a loyal and caring member of the group. He even stood up against other bullies, using his size and strength to protect those who couldn't defend themselves. Finn's impact on Spike didn't go unnoticed. The other fish admired Finn's ability to bring out the best in others and turn negative situations into opportunities for growth and understanding. He had a special gift for fostering unity and harmony among different fish, no matter how different they might be. As the years went by, Finn's legend grew even further. He was now known not only for his playful adventures but also for his ability to turn foes into friends and make the ocean a safer and happier place for all its inhabitants. One day, as Finn swam through the colorful coral reefs, an old fish approached him. "You must be Finn," the elder fish said with a smile. "We've heard so much about you and your remarkable journey." Finn blushed modestly and replied, "I'm just doing what feels right and following my heart." The wise old fish nodded. "And that, my young friend, is what makes you truly special. You have a gift for bringing out the best in others and creating a sense of community. Your legacy will live on for generations to come." Finn felt a sense of fulfillment as he continued his adventures, knowing that he had made a positive impact on the ocean and its inhabitants. He understood that being mischievous didn't mean being harmful. It could be channeled into something greater, into making the world a better place, one friendly gesture at a time. And so, the legend of the mischievous but wise and kind fish named Finn lived on, inspiring new generations to embrace their unique qualities and use them to create a more compassionate and harmonious world beneath the waves.
As the years passed, Finn's adventures took him to distant and enchanting parts of the ocean. He explored mysterious shipwrecks, swam alongside gentle giant whales, and befriended schools of colorful fish from all corners of the sea. One day, as he swam through a sunken city deep below the ocean surface, Finn came across a lonely and melancholic fish named Luna. Luna was a graceful moonfish with shimmering silver scales that glowed softly in the darkness of the deep ocean. But despite her beauty, Luna felt isolated and disconnected from the other fish. Curious as ever, Finn approached Luna with a warm smile and said, "Hello there, Luna. You seem like such an extraordinary fish. Why are you all alone down here?" Luna sighed softly, "I am different from the other fish. My glow scares them away, and they think I'm strange." Finn replied empathetically, "I understand how it feels to be seen as different. But trust me, your glow is what makes you unique and special. Embrace it, and you'll find true friends who appreciate you for who you are." Luna hesitated, but was touched by Finn's words. She decided to take a chance and join Finn on his adventures. As they swam together, Finn introduced her to his diverse group of friends, each one with their own quirks and qualities. The more time Luna spent with Finn's group, the more she felt accepted and understood. Her radiant glow not only illuminated the ocean, but also brought joy and wonder to her new friends. They appreciated her uniqueness and realized that being different was what made their group even more extraordinary. As they continued their adventures, Finn and his friends encountered various challenges threatening the ocean's beauty and harmony. From oil spills to plastic pollution, they saw how human actions were harming their underwater home. Finn knew they had to take action. Gathering their collective strengths and talents, Finn's group began organizing cleanup efforts and spreading awareness about protecting the ocean. They spoke to schools of fish, held underwater rallies, and even collaborated with wise old creatures to devise solutions to environmental issues. Their efforts didn't go unnoticed. Fish from other parts of the ocean started joining them in their cause. The movement grew, and soon, their positive influence rippled throughout the entire marine world. Finn's group became a beacon of hope, showing that even small fish like themselves could make a big difference. Their actions inspired other ocean dwellers to become stewards of their underwater realm, preserving its beauty for generations to come. Years later, when Finn had become a seasoned fish, he realized that he had found his true purpose. It wasn't just about exploring and having fun, it was about making a positive impact on the world and helping others find their place in it. Finn's legacy as the mischievous, wise, and kind fish continued to thrive. He had touched the lives of countless creatures, from playful dolphins to shy seahorses, spreading compassion and understanding wherever he swam. And so, the story of Finn, the naughty baby fish who grew up to be a hero of the ocean, lived on as a timeless tale of friendship, acceptance, and the power of making a difference. And in the vast and colorful ocean, his legend remained alive, inspiring new generations to believe that no matter how small they might be, they could change the world for the better.
As the ocean continued to change, so did Finn and his friends. They witnessed the consequences of climate change as coral reefs bleached, sea levels rose, and some fish species faced extinction. The challenges ahead were immense, but Finn's determination only grew stronger. With the support of his friends, Finn started to organize an annual Ocean Conservation Day. This event brought together fish from all corners of the ocean to discuss ways to protect their home. It became a tradition where different species, big and small, shared their unique knowledge and experiences. As the face of Ocean Conservation Day, Finn gave motivational speeches that touched the hearts of all who listened. His words spread like currents, inspiring fish to take action in their own communities and make a positive impact on the world around them. Through their collective efforts, Finn's group successfully advocated for the establishment of marine protected areas and worked with human conservationists to promote sustainable fishing practices. They also collaborated with underwater researchers to gather valuable data and understand the ocean's changing dynamics better. During one memorable expedition, Finn and his friends encountered an injured sea turtle trapped in discarded fishing gear. With quick thinking and teamwork, they managed to free the turtle and nursed it back to health. The grateful sea turtle, named Sandy, joined their mission to protect the ocean. As the years went by, Finn's influence reached even the human world. His story inspired children's books, documentaries, and art installations that spread awareness about ocean conservation. People around the globe began to see the ocean through a new lens, not just as a vast expanse of water, but as a delicate ecosystem deserving of protection and care. Finn's fame reached such heights that humans recognized him as a symbol of hope and conservation. Scores of children looked up to him, and young fish dreamt of growing up to be as brave and compassionate as Finn. But for Finn, the most fulfilling part was seeing the positive change taking place. The once shy and isolated Luna became a leader in her own right, heading initiatives to protect other misunderstood creatures like herself. Spike became a mentor to younger fish, guiding them away from bullying behaviors and encouraging understanding and empathy. Finn knew that his legacy extended beyond his own lifetime. He was part of a movement, a wave of change that would continue long after he was gone. And so, with his friends by his side, Finn continued his mission, swimming tirelessly through the vast ocean, touching hearts, and inspiring a new generation of ocean stewards. And so, the tale of Finn, the naughty baby fish who grew up to be an ocean conservation hero, echoed through the underwater world and beyond. His journey taught everyone that no matter how small or young they might be, they had the power to make a difference and create a brighter future for all living beings that called the ocean their home.
How the mischievous little fish became a hero.
Once upon a time in the vast and colorful ocean, there was a little fish named Finn. Finn was a curious and adventurous baby fish, always eager to explore the underwater world and meet new friends. But there was something special about Finn. He had a mischievous side that often got him into trouble. One sunny morning, Finn woke up feeling particularly mischievous. Instead of joining the school of fish for their daily swim, he decided to sneak away to the forbidden part of the reef, where the older fish had warned him not to go. They said there were dangerous creatures lurking there, but Finn couldn't resist the temptation. As Finn swam deeper into the forbidden reef, he encountered a grouchy old hermit crab named Crusty. "Hey, you! What are you doing in my territory?" Crusty snapped, waving his pincers threateningly. Finn giggled nervously and replied, "I'm just exploring, Mr. Crusty. I didn't mean to intrude." But Crusty was not amused. Youngsters these days have no respect for boundaries. "You better leave before you get hurt," he grumbled. Finn didn't listen and continued his misadventure. He soon found himself in front of a beautiful but mysterious cave. It was said that a grumpy octopus named Octo lived there, and no fish dared to disturb him. However, Finn's naughty streak pushed him forward, and he swam right into the cave. Inside, he found Octo, who was napping. Finn couldn't resist playing a prank on the sleeping octopus. He swam up to Octo and tickled one of his tentacles. Octo woke up with a start, his eyes wide with surprise and irritation. "Why, you little rascal! Who dares to disturb my peaceful nap?" Octo roared. Finn gulped but managed a sheepish smile. "Sorry, Mr. Octo. I couldn't resist having a bit of fun." Octo's stern expression softened as he chuckled. "You have spunk, kid, I'll give you that. But remember, not all creatures have a sense of humor. Be careful with your pranks next time." Finn nodded, realizing that his mischievous behavior could have serious consequences. He thanked Octo for his advice and promised to be more careful in the future. As Finn swam back towards his school, he reflected on his escapade. He understood that his curiosity and mischievous nature were not inherently bad, but he needed to channel them in a more responsible and considerate way. From that day on, Finn still had his playful moments, but he became more mindful of his actions. He learned to respect boundaries and consider the feelings of others. His friends appreciated his adventurous spirit and humor, and together, they explored the ocean, forming a close-knit group that always looked out for one another. And so, the little naughty fish named Finn grew up to be a wise and kind fish, who shared his tales of adventure with the younger generations, encouraging them to explore while also reminding them to be mindful of their actions. And in the colorful world of the ocean, Finn's legacy of playful curiosity lived on. As Finn grew older, his reputation as a wise and kind fish spread throughout the ocean. Other young fish looked up to him, seeking his guidance and friendship. He became the go-to fish for solving disputes and helping others navigate through challenges. One day, while exploring a coral reef with his friends, Finn noticed a group of younger fish being picked on by a bully fish named Spike. Spike was much larger than the others and enjoyed intimidating smaller fish for his amusement. Finn knew he couldn't let this behavior continue. Swimming over to Spike, Finn calmly asked, "Hey, why are you bothering these little ones? Can't we all just get along?" Spike sneered, "Mind your own business, wise guy. It's fun to see them squirm." Finn wasn't one to back down, and he replied firmly, "Bullying isn't cool, and it doesn't make you any better. Let's find a way to have fun without hurting others." Spike hesitated for a moment, surprised that someone was standing up to him. Deep down, he felt lonely and insecure, using his tough exterior to hide his feelings. Finn sensed this and saw an opportunity to help him change. Instead of resorting to a fight, Finn decided to invite Spike to join their group in a more positive way. "You know, we have a lot of fun exploring the ocean and discovering new places. You're more than welcome to come along," Finn said warmly. Spike was taken aback by Finn's offer. Nobody had ever invited him to join before. Slowly, he nodded and said, "Okay, I guess I could give it a try." From that day on, Finn and his friends welcomed Spike into their group. As they explored together, Spike's tough exterior softened, and he began to feel a sense of belonging he had never experienced before. Finn's kindness and acceptance taught Spike the value of friendship and compassion. Over time, Spike's bullying tendencies faded away, and he became a loyal and caring member of the group. He even stood up against other bullies, using his size and strength to protect those who couldn't defend themselves. Finn's impact on Spike didn't go unnoticed. The other fish admired Finn's ability to bring out the best in others and turn negative situations into opportunities for growth and understanding. He had a special gift for fostering unity and harmony among different fish, no matter how different they might be. As the years went by, Finn's legend grew even further. He was now known not only for his playful adventures but also for his ability to turn foes into friends and make the ocean a safer and happier place for all its inhabitants. One day, as Finn swam through the colorful coral reefs, an old fish approached him. "You must be Finn," the elder fish said with a smile. "We've heard so much about you and your remarkable journey." Finn blushed modestly and replied, "I'm just doing what feels right and following my heart." The wise old fish nodded. "And that, my young friend, is what makes you truly special. You have a gift for bringing out the best in others and creating a sense of community. Your legacy will live on for generations to come." Finn felt a sense of fulfillment as he continued his adventures, knowing that he had made a positive impact on the ocean and its inhabitants. He understood that being mischievous didn't mean being harmful, it could be channeled into something greater, into making the world a better place, one friendly gesture at a time. And so, the legend of the mischievous but wise and kind fish named Finn lived on, inspiring new generations to embrace their unique qualities and use them to create a more compassionate and harmonious world beneath the waves.
As the years passed, Finn's adventures took him to distant and enchanting parts of the ocean. He explored mysterious shipwrecks, swam alongside gentle giant whales, and befriended schools of colorful fish from all corners of the sea. One day, as he swam through a sunken city deep below the ocean's surface, Finn came across a lonely and melancholic fish named Luna. Luna was a graceful moonfish with shimmering silver scales that glowed softly in the darkness of the deep ocean. But despite her beauty, Luna felt isolated and disconnected from the other fish. Curious as ever, Finn approached Luna with a warm smile and said, "Hello there, Luna. You seem like such an extraordinary fish. Why are you all alone down here?" Luna sighed softly, "I am different from the other fish. My glow scares them away, and they think I'm strange." Finn replied empathetically, "I understand how it feels to be seen as different. But trust me, your glow is what makes you unique and special. Embrace it, and you'll find true friends who appreciate you for who you are." Luna hesitated but was touched by Finn's words. She decided to take a chance and join Finn on his adventures. As they swam together, Finn introduced her to his diverse group of friends, each one with their own quirks and qualities. The more time Luna spent with Finn's group, the more she felt accepted and understood. Her radiant glow not only illuminated the ocean but also brought joy and wonder to her new friends. They appreciated her uniqueness and realized that being different was what made their group even more extraordinary. As they continued their adventures, Finn and his friends encountered various challenges threatening the ocean's beauty and harmony. From oil spills to plastic pollution, they saw how human actions were harming their underwater home. Finn knew they had to take action. Gathering their collective strengths and talents, Finn's group began organizing cleanup efforts and spreading awareness about protecting the ocean. They spoke to schools of fish, held underwater rallies, and even collaborated with wise old creatures to devise solutions to environmental issues. Their efforts didn't go unnoticed. Fish from other parts of the ocean started joining them in their cause. The movement grew, and soon, their positive influence rippled throughout the entire marine world. Finn's group became a beacon of hope, showing that even small fish like themselves could make a big difference. Their actions inspired other ocean dwellers to become stewards of their underwater realm, preserving its beauty for generations to come. Years later, when Finn had become a seasoned fish, he realized that he had found his true purpose. It wasn't just about exploring and having fun, it was about making a positive impact on the world and helping others find their place in it. Finn's legacy as the mischievous, wise, and kind fish continued to thrive. He had touched the lives of countless creatures, from playful dolphins to shy seahorses, spreading compassion and understanding wherever he swam. And so, the story of Finn, the naughty baby fish who grew up to be a hero of the ocean, lived on as a timeless tale of friendship, acceptance, and the power of making a difference. And in the vast and colorful ocean, his legend remained alive, inspiring new generations to believe that no matter how small they might be, they could change the world for the better.
As the ocean continued to change, so did Finn and his friends. They witnessed the consequences of climate change as coral reefs bleached, sea levels rose, and some fish species faced extinction. The challenges ahead were immense, but Finn's determination only grew stronger. With the support of his friends, Finn started to organize an annual Ocean Conservation Day. This event brought together fish from all corners of the ocean to discuss ways to protect their home. It became a tradition where different species, big and small, shared their unique knowledge and experiences. As the face of Ocean Conservation Day, Finn gave motivational speeches that touched the hearts of all who listened. His words spread like currents, inspiring fish to take action in their own communities and make a positive impact on the world around them. Through their collective efforts, Finn's group successfully advocated for the establishment of marine protected areas and worked with human conservationists to promote sustainable fishing practices. They also collaborated with underwater researchers to gather valuable data and understand the ocean's changing dynamics better. During one memorable expedition, Finn and his friends encountered an injured sea turtle trapped in discarded fishing gear. With quick thinking and teamwork, they managed to free the turtle and nursed it back to health. The grateful sea turtle, named Sandy, joined their mission to protect the ocean. As the years went by, Finn's influence reached even the human world. His story inspired children's books, documentaries, and art installations that spread awareness about ocean conservation. People around the globe began to see the ocean through a new lens, not just as a vast expanse of water, but as a delicate ecosystem deserving of protection and care. Finn's fame reached such heights that humans recognized him as a symbol of hope and conservation. Scores of children looked up to him, and young fish dreamt of growing up to be as brave and compassionate as Finn. But for Finn, the most fulfilling part was seeing the positive change taking place. The once shy and isolated Luna became a leader in her own right, heading initiatives to protect other misunderstood creatures like herself. Spike became a mentor to younger fish, guiding them away from bullying behaviors and encouraging understanding and empathy. Finn knew that his legacy extended beyond his own lifetime. He was part of a movement, a wave of change that would continue long after he was gone. And so, with his friends by his side, Finn continued his mission, swimming tirelessly through the vast ocean, touching hearts, and inspiring a new generation of ocean stewards. And so, the tale of Finn, the naughty baby fish who grew up to be an ocean conservation hero, echoed through the underwater world and beyond. His journey taught everyone that no matter how small or young they might be, they had the power to make a difference and create a brighter future for all living beings that called the ocean their home.